Hello and greetings from Iceland. Yet another volcanotour from North Iceland to Reykjavík has just started. My third tour in order to film the next eruption that could be growing in size every day. And what triggered my departure this time was a comment that Professor Þorvaldur Þórðarson made last Thursday, or when he said that the next eruption would likely take place in the next 3 days. And that was enough for me. The seismometers had been going crazy for almost 2 days, just by Grindavík, and to see some of that energy trigger the eruption there sounded not unlikely. So I just threw my stuff in the car and took off. And after the first 100 kilometers, the windshield broke due to a small rock coming from another car. But I'm insured and this is not interrupting my tour. And after 200 kilometers, I checked the seismometers online only to find out that not one single earthquake could be detected under the country since I took off. And after 300 kilometers, that hadn't changed. So my mind wandered to Professor Þorvaldur. Or was he about to send me on another wild goose chase? And I actually mentioned him in my last update, or if I should send the professor the fuel bill when he is telling me to take off when it's not needed. But when I arrived to the city, I decided to forgive him if he made a mistake and try to enjoy the weekend, get some filming done. And I did a good tour up to the craters and I've already made that into a video that is online. But the weather was lame on Sunday, so although I did my usual tour to Grindavík, I didn't film anything. And last night, Sunday night, when this 3 day time frame that the professor gave us was running out, he appeared in the media with another statement saying that magma could already be on the way to the surface since the ground had already started to subside. And that left me with a few options. One of them was to make a video saying that this is about to start and to take off to the Reykjanes Peninsula after that, because there was actually a little uptick in seismic activity that supported what the professor was saying. It wasn't enough to convince me fully, so I decided to wait, and that turned out to be right. So I got some sleep so this day would not turn into nothing. And the tension here is growing by the hour. And overall, I'm sure that we Icelanders are more or less all willing to forgive the professor for this shout-out. That was not decreasing the tension. And we Icelanders are actually lucky to have many fine scientists who are commenting on this situation in the media frequently. But only a few of them allow themselves to speculate outside the box. So it's easy for me to understand when some of the more careful experts are asking, show me the evidence. And the reason for why Professor Þorvaldur gets all of this media attention is quite normal, since every now and then he gets his long shots right from experience. And he always provides us with informative comments. He is the only expert who wanted Grindavík evacuated before the November 10th event in 2023. But we did the careful approach that day. And although the Met Office was fully aware of what was going on real time, it was the civil defense and their own science team that failed to give the order to evacuate until the situation had become so bad that when the order finally came, the people had already evacuated the town. So that careful approach that left many with nightmares still today, because this was no ordinary evening in Grindavík. And it was the day before the evacuation that a PR representative got the task to write an article about how dangerous it was to have volcanologists coming up with wild theories like evacuation in Grindavík. And I still have that article somewhere. And what I'm trying to say is that my own science approach is to listen to all the experts, the whole spectrum. And this is in a way just a big guessing game. That is a fact. modern science knowledge in geology has never witnessed this scenario here in Iceland before. And what we are doing now is simply to give the science community the facilities and the resources needed to get as much data as possible from those events. And the Icelandic media, they have been doing a good job covering this, not just with the webcams, but also by allowing as many experts as possible to express themselves, because it is so very obvious that there is no one expert with all the answers. And it is not the role of the media to handpick scientific views. So I can forgive Professor Þorvaldur, and I'm actually very thankful for his approach, for having the guts to express himself outside the box and take certain risk that not all are willing to do. And that approach has contributed a lot to my channel, as I have cited them numerous times and will continue to do so. But as for the next days, I'm working on some video files that are shot during this trip and also during my last tour. So those tours, they left me with lots of good footage actually. And one of my next videos will be about the webcam locations, just to help you to see the big picture better. And I did actually do several 360 drone circles that deserve to be online. But most importantly, we just hope that this eruption will start soon. The sooner it takes off, the more likely it is that our infrastructure will hold. And the longer that this waiting game goes on, it increases the likelihood of yet another surprise that could even be in the form of new location. And even our most careful scientists, they say that this could start any day now. So I'm not going to the north just yet. I'm going to give this a chance for a few more days, see where this takes us, and just hope that this turns out well for the town and the infrastructure by searching. So we remain hopeful despite the tension. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.